Today, I'm going to be teaching you how to make use of the multi-band 6 functionality of your gshock, even if you do not live within one of the 6 available radio towers. As a bonus, I'm also going to reveal another series of gshock that lets you achieve the same perfectly accurate time without the need for multi-band 6, so stick around to the end. I know how important it is to keep the exact atomic time. And as you know, digital watches tend to stray by a few seconds each month or so. It doesn't seem like a lot, but a couple of years back, I had a situation where everyone was out of sync on our New Year's Eve countdown because of this very problem. I put in a lot of research to fix this very problem, and I'd love to share it with you. I want to make sure that you are subscribed as well so that you don't miss out on our next watch tips and tricks. So, my research led me to a phone application known as Clockwave, and this is the app that we're going to be using. The Clockwave app is available in the Android App Store as well as the iOS App Store, and it is not a free app. But I will say, I did explore all of the free apps, and they were all written in Chinese, and it was not worth the hassle. So I was very much willing to drop just $2 on the Clockwave app. So I'm now going to jump into a demonstration of how to use the Clockwave app for you. But just before we do, I need to give a special thank you to one of my favorite viewers, Fratellini, and he was the one who had the idea for this video. So a big thank you. And now let's get in to the demo. The Clockwave app is super simple to use. We just have transmit and settings. So we're going to set it up first. In settings, we're going to pick one of the available tower frequencies. I'm going to go with China, and I'd also recommend auto stop after 10 minutes in case you forget about it. So now we're going to hit save and move on to setting up our gshock. The first thing I need to do with my gshock is set the home time zone. So we're going to hold the top left button for a few seconds, and we're just going to toggle the home time away from mine, which at the moment is on Hong Kong. Scroll that back to Beijing so that it matches the China we selected on the app, and then we cancel that and we're ready to go. Next, from our gshock's home menu, we just press the bottom left button once, and as you can see, we're now in the get screen. So to start the receiving process, we hold down the bottom right, hold, and we are now in the receiving option. With our gshock now actively searching for the signal, it's just a matter of setting up our phone with the speakers facing the gshock. I'm going to deploy my pop stand to get a good angle against it, and I'm also going to start a stopwatch on my F91W and then hit transmit. So we're going to keep track of how long it takes. So the bottom right has just jumped to L1, and that's the level of signal strength. So we are going to see over time that will escalate. And once we hit L3, that's when you know that the signal should be successful. There's level 2, and there's level 3. So we're going to keep waiting, and just before I speed through this and we check the timer, I just wanted to mention this audio. I don't know if you can hear that, but there's a very high-pitched beeping noise which is transmitting, so we'll be back shortly. There we go. So I'm going to hit stop transmitting and stop on the F91W. So that took us about 3.5 minutes to get a successful transmission. So I'm going to move the phone out of the way, and let's take a look at the gshock now. So you'll notice that at the top left, we have the symbol RCVD, which stands for received. So now if we exit from the get menu, we'll notice that the received symbol stays there, and that lets us know that today this watch was able to successfully synchronize to multi-band 6. As a quick demo, I do want to swap the zone to Japan as an example, and I'm going to hit transmit just so that you can hear. On this Japanese setting, there is no high-pitched beeping. There's almost an infrequent clicking noise, so that's a lot more manageable, and if I was going to continue to do this, that's the setting I would use. Now, in full transparency, I had not been using this app up until today since I bought it months ago, because in the China broadcasting frequency, it was so noisy and disruptive that my wife got super upset when I was trying to sync my watch. So now that I've figured out that the Japanese mode is much less disruptive, I might actually continue to use this app to sync my time. So I'd love to hear what you think. Is it worth using the Clockwave app, or would you rather manually set your time when needed? Let me know. Now, smash that like button because I've got another solution to show you that's really interesting, and after that we've got the bonus, so stick around. So this next solution to multiband 6 also came from Fratellini, the awesome viewer who gave us this idea, and he's recommended an article on how to build a home transmitter, and you actually build it using a 3D printer and Arduino. So here's some pictures, and I don't actually have the parts to build this one myself, but I found it extremely interesting, and I thought you guys may too. So I'm going to leave the design files and the instructions for you below. And thanks again, Fratellini, for your valuable contribution. Alright, it's time for the bonus. We're going to go through the series of gshock that lets you get around multiband 6 by syncing the time in another way. And if you've been getting value from this, don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss our next watch tips and reviews. So if neither of the previous solutions were ideal for you, you don't want to have to sync using an app, and you don't want to have to build your own custom kit, you can simply buy another model of gshock, and this is the GWB5600. And the way this works is by using Bluetooth. And I use the term works very loosely because, as you can see, mine is busted. And if you missed out on the video where I revealed how that happened, I'm leaving that for you above. But just know that the GWB5600 series has a Bluetooth receiver that allows you to schedule synchronization with your smartphone up to a couple of times a day. All you'll need to do so is the free gshock app, which you'll then pair with your gshock, and you'll then have a perfectly synchronized time every day. So if you would like to get your hands on one of these GWB5600 and just use Bluetooth instead of multiband 6, I'm leaving a link for you in the description below. I'm going to leave you with the story of how I broke my GW5600, as well as our recent review of the F91W. And do consider subscribing so you don't miss our next watch content. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next review.